Hi guys, you're welcome back to my channel. On today's tutorial, I'm going to be making another requested tutorial. The one on the thumbnail was made with crepe fabric and I decided to make mine with African print because it's a requested tutorial. Now if you would like to use crepe fabric for yours, I'm going to be showing you the type of crepe you will use, but for mine I decided to use African print for the sake of this tutorial. Please make sure you watch to the end because I'm going to be showing you in detail on how to cut and sew this dress you are seeing on the screen. Please, if you find my video helpful, make sure you subscribe to my channel and turn on your notification bell. And please don't skip any part so that you won't miss any important information. Alright, this is the fabric that you need to buy if you want to use crepe fabric. As you can see, the fabric is very thick. This is the one that I'll be using for this tutorial. But when you are making yours, make sure you buy a thick crepe. Can you see the texture of the fabric so that the sleeve will stand very well because we are not going to be using liner for this dress. So this is the paper that I'll be working with. You put it on fold. So the first thing I'll be doing now is to mark a vertical measurement. I'll put a measurement on the screen. So to get the chest line depth, you divide a round chest by 4. This calculation is standard and it works for all children. So I have marked the value that I got. I will come down by 10 inches to mark her waistline. From her shoulder to her blouse length is 18 inches. I'll go ahead and rule the lines out. After that, the next thing I'll do now is to input her shoulder measurement. So I'll divide her shoulder width by 2. Whatever I get, I will mark it here and I will rule the line down to the chest line. For the neck width and neck depth, you'll be doing a little calculation. This calculation is for me to get the standard neckline for children. To do that, you divide the round chest by 12. Please note that the round chest is the same thing as round bust. So if I divide 25 by 12, I have 2 inches. That is to say 2 inches by width and 2 inches by depth. But because I want the turtleneck to be well fitted and well relaxed, I'll be minusing 1/2 inch for the neck depth. So I'll mark 1.5 inches for the neck depth and I'll mark 2 inches for the neck width. Please, if you're making a turtleneck for children, don't use more than 1.5 inches for the neck depth. If you make the neck depth so deep, the turtleneck will not come out well. It won't be fitted and it won't relax on the neck. So for the shoulder slant, I came down by 1 inch. And I will connect it back to the neck width the way you see me doing. So I will divide the chest line by 2. I want to determine the midpoint. So whatever I get, I will mark it here and I will come in by 1/2 inch on that midpoint. I will connect it just to draw my armhole. Just curve it the way you see me doing. Alright, please, if you find my video helpful, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. On the chest line depth, I marked 1/4 of her round chest. I added 1 inch for sewing allowance. I do the same thing on the half length. Divide her round waist by 4. You add your sewing allowance. On the full length of the blouse, I mark her round hip. And I added 1 inch for sewing allowance. I'll connect it the way you see me doing. After connecting the line, the next thing I'll be doing now is to cut it off. But I won't be cutting the armhole because I'll be using this front pattern to trace out the back part. So I'm cutting on the first line and I will not cut the shoulder slant for the front. I will not cut the neckline. On the down part by this side, I will come up by 1 inch because I don't want it to have a sharp point and I'll connect it the way you see me doing. After trimming it off, I will place it on the back part. I've already marked out my zipper allowance and I place it on that zipper allowance line. I will trim it out. My back part is not folded. I folded the front part because we'll be doing slash and spray method on the front part. If you take the picture on the thumbnail, you find out that the neck area have a little pleat. For the back neck width, I also marked 2 inches and for the back neck depth, I use 1/2 inch. Please don't use more than 1/2 inch if you want to achieve a well-fitted turtleneck for children. Can you see what I have? So I'll connect it with a slight curve. After connecting it, I'll mark 1/2 inch for the shoulder slope for the back. I will slant it to the neck width. I won't be doing any adjustment on the armhole, so I'll go ahead and trim it out. After cutting it out, I will cut out the front neckline. After cutting it out, I will unfold it. So I will be showing you how you can achieve the pleating on the neckline. First of all, you measure the round neckline and you will write it down so that you will not forget. I've already measured mine. So the next thing I'll do now is to the length of where I want the pleating to stop. I measured down 5 inches, but I later open it up to 8 inches. So you mark it. So I'll be slashing it here first. So I'll be marking half inch, or you can mark 1/1 inch. The main target is to create enough allowance for the pleating. So after marking it out, I will be slashing it open. Can you see what I'm doing? I'll slash it this way and I will spread it out. Please make sure you measure the round neckline before you slash it open so that you know what you have there. Because after pleating it, you will go back to the original neckline. So you'll open it up a little more. I've already spread the pattern on my fabric, as you can see. I'll use my pin to hold it down. And once after spreading it out, I will have the neckline of 10 inches, or you can make it 11 inches. So I will open it up a little more so that I can get what I want. After that, I will pin it down. Just spread it out and you measure what you have before you cut it out. So the next thing I'll be doing now is to dress it. I just watch how I'm cutting it. I did not add any other sewing allowance on the neckline. Please take note of that. So I just hold it this way. Just hold it the way you see me doing. And you trace it out. I'm cutting out the shoulder line now. Can you see what I have? I will now trace everything out. If you find my video helpful, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more interesting videos. Alright? So I'm done cutting it out. Can you see what I have? So I'll be pleating it this way. When I'm sewing it, I will show you how you can do all that. So I will also transfer my back pattern to my fabric and I'll cut it out. So the next thing I'll do now is to achieve the pleating on the neck area. So I'll be doing a tiny pleat. Just watch what I'm doing. You get it right. If you pleat it, use your pin to hold it down. I'll pleat it up to the original neckline you had before you slash it open. That's why I say you need to measure your round neckline before slashing it open, so that you know where you stop your pleating. Alright? So, after pleating, I will measure what I have. Just confirm what you have on your neckline to know whether you are on the right track. So, mine is correct. The next thing I'll do now is to go to my sewing machine and stitch it down. After stitching it down, I will place the back part shoulder to shoulder. I will stitch the shoulder down. I will also do the same thing on this side. I'll go and do it and come back and show you the next thing to do. Okay, I'm done stitching it down. Can you see what I have here? This is what you have when you are done sewing yours. So I will now measure what I have on my neckline. We confirm it so that you know what you should be having there. So I have about 5.5 inches. That's what I have, plus my 1 inch sewing allowance, making it 6.5 inches. That's what should be having. So before I cut the collar for the turtleneck, I will first of all insert my zip. So I'll go to my sewing machine now and fix my zip. As you can see, I've already attached my zip. I did not cut out the excess zipper. You understand the reason for that as this video progresses. Can you see what I have? It's coming out already. So the next thing now is to confirm your shoulder width. Okay, mine is correct. There's no need of shaping it. If you have excess, you can trim it off. So the next thing is to measure what I have on my neckline. Can you see how I folded it? So I will open up the zip because I want the collar to extend to the zipper allowance. So I'll measure it from there. I have 5.5 inches plus 1 inch zipper allowance. So I'll be using this paper to illustrate how you can fold it and how you can cut it out. You can cut it directly on your fabric. It's still the same thing. So I have folded my paper into two. I'll be cutting out two collars. So after folding it into two, I'll fold it into four this way. Can you see what I have? This part is folded. The two parts is folded and this side is also folded. First of all, rule a line for my starting point. I just rule a straight line for my starting point. So this part now is folded. Can you see? So from here now, I will measure 1.5 inches for the width of the collar and I will measure 5.5 inches for the length of the collar. The 5.5 inches is the value we got when we measured the round neckline. So I add 1 inch for the zipper allowance, that is 6.5 inches plus half inch for sewing allowance. So I will now connect it and I will rule a straight line. Can you see what I have? At this end, I'll be coming down by half inch. You know, our neckline is not straight, it's curved. So this side too, I will measure half inch. So I will connect it. Can you see how I'm covering it? So this part is the part I'll be attaching on the neckline. So I will curve it. Our neck is not straight. So if I cut it out, you see the shape. Next thing I'll be doing now is to cut it out. After cutting it out, I'll separate it. Can you see? I have two. This is what you should be having when you are cutting directly on your fabric. So you use one as the lining. So I will match it on the neckline now for you to see what I have. Can you see? No excess. So I will notch this part that I'll be attaching on the neckline. Please don't forget to notch it. So I'll be transferring it to my fabric now. I'll cut two of it. I've cut it already. I added half inch sewing allowance on the both sides. Can you see what I have? If you cut directly on your fabric, remember that you add your sewing allowance on the fabric. So I'm marking how I sew it so that you understand. On this side, I will not sew it to the end. I'll stop half inch. This half inch I left is where I'll be using to attach it on the neckline. I do the same thing on this side. But before you sew it, iron your extension on it to stabilize it. I've gone ahead to sew it. Can you see? Please make sure you backstitch on where you stop your stitches. Can you see? I will turn it to the right side now. This is what I have. I will iron it very well. Make sure you open press and iron. I'll turn it this way and also iron it. So I'll be attaching one part on the neckline. Just watch what I'm doing. You get it right. So I'll loosen the zipper allowance up to half inch. Can you see? You do the same thing on the other side. So I will attach it this way from the wrong side. Just fix your eyes on the screen. You understand what I'm doing. Can you see what I'm doing? One part of the collar, one side is open. I'll go and stitch it now and come back and show you. I've already stitched it. Can you see? I've pushed the sewing allowance inside. Just arrange it. This is just a normal way to fix a collar. Push it inside and top stitch on it. Just fold the half inch on the other part of the collar and top stitch on it. This is very simple. So I will do it now. After top stitching on it, what you will do is to stitch your zip up to the collar. Just finish it off and cut out the excess zipper. So this is what I have when I was done attaching the collar. I will now stitch down my zip. After stitching it down, I'll fold it this way and tack it down. This is very simple. Next thing I'll be showing you is how to cut the sleeve part. So what you will do is to measure the round armhole. If you did not take it on your client or on your child, you just measure it on the dress. So I have 6.5 inches. The next thing I will do now is to cut out the fabric that I'll use for my sleeve. I've already cut it out, so I'll be showing you the measurement I have here. The total length of the sleeve is 12 inches. So from shoulder to 7 inches is where I'll be using to form my puff. So I'll measure 7 inches and I'll add extra 5 inches because I want the sleeve to be dropping. If you check the sleeve on the thumbnail, you understand. From the further, I'll measure half of her around armhole, which is 6.5 inches. I'll add extra 6 inches depending on how full you want the sleeve to be. This extra inches is what I will use to form my gathers. All right. So if you measure from her shoulder to the 7 inches, on the 7 inches length, you measure the round sleeve. The round sleeve I'm working with is 8 inches. So I've cut out the one that I'll use for the pencil sleeve. The length is 5 inches. 7 plus 5 will give you the total length of the sleeve. Just take the accurate measurement of the person you are sewing the clothes for and work with your own measurements. I have 8 inches here. I'll add 1/2 inch for sewing allowance. So what I will do now is to separate it. I'll be cutting one sleeve first. So I'll come down by 3 inches for her cap height. You can as well divide her round chest by 12 and add 1 inch. The 1 inch is because we are making a puff sleeve. That's why I added 1 inch. So I will measure half of her round armhole, which is 6. I will curve it this way. Okay, see? And I will rule it straight down. I'll cut it out now and place it on the other one to cut the other sleeve. So I'll do it off camera and come back and show you the next thing to do. After cutting it out, I'll go to my sewing machine now and pleat it. Just form your gathers. Start pleating it. Make sure that what you have left is up to your round armhole. So I will also gather this down part up to the round sleeve. That's the 8 inches round sleeve. So I'll pleat it now and show you what I have. Can you see? This is what you have. So the next thing I will do now is to confirm the measurement I have here. I have 7 inches. It's very accurate. So I will now attach this one. Just flip it backward and sew it with 1/2 inch. And I will shape the side. After shaping it, I will attach it to my sleeve. Can you see the one that I've done already? I'll go ahead and do for the other sleeve. After that, I'll iron it. Thanks for watching.